Lithuanian reporter on Ball brothers' exit, LaVar Ball. LaVar, LiAngelo and LaMelo Ball arrived in Lithuania on January 3, to enormous fanfare. The younger brothers of Lonzo Ball were foregoing their college eligibility to play professional basketball for BC Vytautas in the small town of Prienai. With that, came a reality show, Big Baller Brand, and, of course, LaVar Ball's clashes with another coach. The disagreements with Vytautas coach Virginijus Seskus ultimately led to LaVar pulling his sons out of Lithuania with two games remaining in the LKL season. Donatas Urbanas, a sports reporter for 15minutes.lt, covered every step of the Ball family's experience in Lithuania. He discussed the whirlwind 3 months in an interview with For the Win. There were probably three parts of the Ball experience in Lithuania. The first month was completely crazy. Everything was new. Everything was kind of shocking. Everything was kind of exciting. We were following with the Ball brothers and what LaVar was saying. What are they going to say about Lithuania? Every step, every move, every word, every new experience in Lithuania was something fun. Then, the second part was kind of coming back to reality. Watching it, we started following more closely. Like, how LaMelo was performing on the court. If LiAngelo was good, and he actually was pretty good. He was very, very underrated coming into Lithuania. We thought probably that LaMelo might contribute more because we saw more potential in Melo's game. Jello is 3 years older and he's more mature for the pro game, but still, we expected more from Melo. But the third month was kind of sad. I don't know if you saw, but during the games that we broadcasted on Facebook, you could tell that there wasn't many people in the stands. Also, the Facebook numbers decreased a lot. Comparing to the first games where we had more than 100,000 people watching, and then in the end, it was like 5 or 6,000 people. It was a picture of the overall attention in Lithuania. We got bored, people got bored. Mostly because we saw that LaMelo can't perform at the pro level yet, and most of the people were irritated with the LaVar and coach Seskus stuff that hurt the team. Also, some of the players had a bad approach to LaMelo and LiAngelo, so these inside conflicts were damaging to the overall image in Lithuania. 3 months is a pretty short time, but it was a very different experience month by month. For me personally, it was strange. I was surprised why LaVar was so mad. The main thing why he was so mad and why he went crazy on the coach was that Seskus didn't put both Ball brothers in the starting lineup. It was the game against Žalgiris, the best team in Lithuania, which actually made the EuroLeague Final Four, Europe's most prestigious tournament. He wanted Seskus to play both brothers in the starting lineup against the best team. The thing is, they actually played a really good game against Žalgiris. They just didn't start, which in Europe isn't really a big business. Sometimes good players are not starting, and who cares because they are playing the crucial minutes and being a game-changing factor. Seskus probably thought that Melo, as a 16-year-old kid, wasn't ready to play against these grown men in the elite league. LaVar got mad, and he didn't want to listen to anybody, not coach Seskus. He didn't want to listen to why he did that. LaVar was fired up just by the fact that LaMelo didn't start. I was surprised, and coach Seskus was surprised too. I don't know, maybe it's language barrier. Seskus just couldn't explain to LaVar everything. Probably, it was the matter of different cultures. LaVar, Jello and Melo are from a different basketball culture, and European basketball is unique in its own way. Probably it was a conflict with basketball cultures. Photo by Alice Kurilioviz, Getty Images. I'd say yes because they were following the Ball history really closely before they signed them. The assistant coach at Vytautas was a big fan of the Ball brothers. He liked Lonzo Ball very much, and he was following him even when he was playing in the NCAA. So I expect the assistant coach, Marius Lenavicius, also knew the history of LaVar's clashes with coaches. It wasn't something surprising to management, but probably the club didn't expect how difficult it would be to handle it. I think we expected that it might be more crazy than it actually was. The biggest concern with Lithuania was that the Ball family was coming here with their reality show, and they're going to make fun of us. Let's be real, Prienai is a very small city. For Americans coming from LA to small town Prienai in the winter, it would have been an easy way to destroy our image. But it wasn't that bad. I don't think the Ball family made this move only because of their reality show. I think LaVar expected to improve his kids' basketball experience of playing at the pro level. For Melo, it was a really big gift because they tried to play him a lot in the beginning, and he did play Jello a lot actually. But maybe as Coach Seskus said, they didn't appreciate the opportunity how they should. They wanted to be successful in both stages, producing a good reality show while improving the kids' basketball experience. The last few weeks have shown that it's gonna be hard. I think Jello got the most out of this experience because he was playing a big number of minutes and contributing really good. It was great for him. I'm kind of scared about Melo because he was not playing much this season. He didn't play at a high level, and Coach Seskus is never known for good practices. So, I'm afraid it was like a setback here for LaMelo. I've talked to a lot of people around Europe who cover the biggest clubs, and, as far as I know, the top clubs don't consider having the Ball brothers or LaMelo on their team. But I feel like there might be another team like Prienai, which had nothing to lose, and might sign him. There's the big plus because Lithuania got so much international attention. And I believe there are some clubs in Europe that want the similar attention, to raise their status, to raise their financial situation. They might try it and have the Ball family there. AFP photo, Petras Malukas. It was an exciting experience because we Lithuanians, we're different. We're not that expressive. We're not so energized, and LaVar is something exceptional. I don't know how his personality is perceived in the USA, but in Lithuania, it was something really new, something really different. He made us laugh. He made us smile, not in a negative way. He was an inspiring figure in Lithuanian basketball for a few months. It was a fun experience for all of Lithuania. And in the end, I was thinking about the advantages and disadvantages of this whole experience. And it really wasn't that bad, actually. In some ways, it helped the club much, to stay, to pay the players. If they weren't here, then probably Prienai would be unable to finish the season because of their financial troubles. Also, Jello played better than we expected. Even the coaches and the players really respected Jello. Coaches in Lithuania didn't understand why there were so many skeptics. He might not be the NBA player, but still, he produced good numbers in the Pro League. So, it was fun. I met LaVar. I had a one-on-one interview. And again, I understand that he's a crazy person, but he has his own arguments. He's a funny guy to listen to. He's a funny guy to have on the sidelines. It was fun. There were some bad moments, some good moments, but nothing that would destroy basketball in our country. Overall, I'd say it was great. More, CC Sabathia gets into heated shouting match with umpire Angel Hernandez. Brazilian surfer broke the world record for surfing an absurd 80-foot wave. CC Sabathia gets into heated shouting match with umpire Angel Hernandez. C. Baker Mayfield's priceless reaction to Jimmy Kimmel's 0-16 Browns joke. Bryce Harper was fed up after getting intentionally walked.